kitchen. Oh, man, we're already giggling and having a good time because Chef George from Portsmouth Publick House is back. And I say he's back because you were in yesterday.
Yes.
And you've developed a new name, a new title for yourself. Yesterday we had the sexiest vegan on, and he was showing us some good workout. And you've deemed yourself the sexiest meatitarian.
Yeah, right.
So why not? So Chef George, the sexiest meatitarian, is making something that requires no meat, actually.
No meat whatsoever.
What do we have?
No meat. It's what it is, if you can think of a creme brulee.
Okay, yes.
But you're making it with butternut squash. It's a vegetable.
Ooh.
So it's a vegetable side dish. We have tons of beautiful butternut squash this time of year.
So this isn't a dessert you can use, or maybe it could be.
Well, you can make it a dessert, but it tastes amazing as a side dish.
As a side.
Yeah.
Okay, great. So what do we need?
So butternut squash, obviously, is the star. Eggs and some sugar, ginger, cinnamon, salt, pepper, and a little bit of cream. You can make this dish a vegan dish. Use half the amount of cream that's required on the recipe and make it with either soy milk or almond milk. I prefer almond milk myself because it's easier to cook with. Soy milk sometimes separates when you're baking it.
That sounds great.
And you got a vegan dish?
Well, look at that. It's simple ingredients, and we're going to get things started when we come back.
We are here in the Roadshow kitchen this morning. Chef George is here. Portsmouth Publick House is the place. And now it's officially Wednesday because George is here. Yesterday, we were a little worried. We didn't know what was going on yesterday.
And we know it's Wednesday because it's raining outside.
It's raining outside. We're glad you're here. The weather's going to be beautiful. You got a great dish that you're going to make for us today.
Yeah, so it's really easy to put together. All I did was, obviously, it takes a lot of time to make because it's a brûlée. So you have to bake it in the oven for 45 minutes, which we don't have the time. So you start off with you cook the butternut squash yourself, cube it and cut
it.
Let it cool down. Put it in your food processor. Just let it run for a couple seconds to emulsify it a little bit.
Sure.
And now we're going to add some eggs.
Okay, so we're going to put a couple. How many eggs you got in here?
Put half the amount of eggs in there.
So we'll drop these in. A couple of these.
Right. So, and the recipe is on the Rhode Show website.
Okay.
It's very, very detailed. So, and now just pulsate it so they all incorporate. All right. There you go.
Got it.
All right. Now add the rest.
Okay.
Just dump the rest of it. So it's six eggs.
And how come we're separating them like this?
Well, because what you want to do is when you put egg in, sometimes all of the white, it's really hard to blend in the food processor because it just kind of doesn't want to do anything.
Yep.
All right. Just pulsate it a couple. All right. Like that. Okay. And then what we're going to do is, because of the brulee, we want to add the egg yolk. So we added six whole eggs and two egg yolks.
All right. So put that in.
So that's going to give it the body.
Okay.
All right, now we're going to pulsate that. And now just add up the seasoning. So we're going to do a pinch of cinnamon. That's ginger, so a pinch of ginger.
Pinch of ginger.
Yep. Or you could zest some fresh ginger. That's
fine. All right,
put that in. A couple pinches of cinnamon.
Okay.
Yeah. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add just a pinch of the salt and pepper.
Mm-hmm. It's already mixed together.
Yeah, I mixed salt and pepper together. Okay. There you go.
Good.
Then we're going to just pulsate that. And then we're going to add the cream.
Okay.
And just add a little bit of cream.
And this whole cream?
Yep. It's going to be we'll have to separate it because your food processor is as big as the one.
So we are going to mix this up.
Yep.
Take this, take a look at this, the finished product just a little bit, and then wait till you see what he has in the oven to show everybody today. Man, oh man, it is a good day here in the Rhode Show kitchen. Back to you. We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Portsmouth Publick House is here. Chef George is here, or as he has us call him off camera, the sexiest Mediterranean.
Well, I am Mediterranean. Yeah, Lebanese is good.
Mediterranean.
Mediterranean.
Either one.
It's all the same.
Like it. That's
tomato, tomato.
That's what you can call them when you get to the restaurant today.
Oh, my goodness.
All
right. Where do we stand? We're making...
There it is. See, if it says it right there, you have to call them that.
Sexiest Mediterranean.
Mediterranean. There you go.
That's excellent. Where do we stand now? You guys, in the last segment, you were blending up the
butternut squash. And the spices and a little bit of the cream.
Butternut squash, which you had cooked beforehand.
Yeah, because the reason why, and I guess I forgot to say that in the last segment, is that if you add the eggs to the hot butternut squash, you're going to get scrambled eggs. So what you do is cook the butternut squash, maybe even the night before. Let it cool down, then add it cold.
Perfect.
And then what we did is we blended it up, and here it is all blended up. And what we're going to do is we're going to put it in ramekin dishes, which are these right here, little shallow dishes. It doesn't have to be something fancy like this. It could be a Pyrex dish.
Whatever
could be a really big one.
Sure.
Whatever works for you guys, right? And then what we want to do is you want to put it in a a pan with water inside of it, because you want to make out a water bath so it doesn't burn. And then you want to fill each one of the dishes halfway up.
So you don't have to put anything on?
That's it.
That's it. Right,
so yeah, and then it goes into an oven, a 325 oven, for about 45 minutes.
Okay.
And then when they're done, I think that's good, Will.
Good.
Right
okay.
there. Perfect. And then when it's done, it's going to come out looking like this.
Wow.
That looks good.
So.
That looks really good.
You know, not burned. And then what we're going to do is now we're going to have the fun part.
Okay.
Is we're going to take the raw sugar.
Yes.
Okay. It has to be raw sugar, not brown sugar. People get confused because it is brown.
It does look like brown. Yes.
You know, but it is raw sugar.
And the granules are larger.
Yeah, they're larger granules. And what you're going to do is you're going to put a little on top. And you're going to just bounce it around.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a nice, even.
Oh, man.
So it's nice and even around the whole top.
Mm-hmm.
And then just be careful with this.
Okay.
All right, I'll get it ignited. And then what you're going to do is you're going to torch it. All right. And just put it about 6 inches away. And a little closer. There you go. And just, you want it so all of the sugar gets liquefied and brown and caramelized. And then you're done.
And you are good to go.
Oh, that smells so yummy.
And you can do that right from the oven. So when they come out of the oven.
Right.
Or you could actually cook these the day before, and then you can pop in the microwave oven for like 35, 40 seconds till they get warmed
so
up.
So good.
And then you just caramelize it up, and then you're good.
And you know what it smells like? A s'more.
Yeah. Well,
it's the sugar.
What happens is you're taking the marshmallow.
But I'm saying that nice roasted smell. It's comforting.
You know? And then, just because I got hands of steel. And then
that one burnt spot that I made.
And that's what it's going to look like.
And that's what it's going to look like. That's great.
Exactly, right there. It's perfect. And then what we would do, like, at our restaurant, right, we would serve this with our, you know, our Thanksgiving Day feast sandwich.
Oh, my gosh. Because if that brûlée wasn't enough, let's pair it
with
an entire turkey.
So you pair it with a Thanksgiving Day feast sandwich, or you'd pair it with anything, or you could, you know, make
this. Wait, that's a sandwich?
Yeah, it's an open-faced sandwich.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
right. There's a little piece of bread under there somewhere. Yeah, this is one person.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man.
So, and
there you go, and you're
and
good to go.
Go. So, all
that
right,
is
it's done.
Beautiful.
That looks good.
Yeah.
All now you've also brought some drinks along too, right?
I'm very gluten free friendly.
Yes. And, which the restaurant is as a whole.
We're trying really hard to become more vegan friendly as well.
Sure.
And so what we did is my business partner Mark, who's a bar connoisseur, brought in this amazing gluten free beer. It's called Bard's. A lot of gluten-free people who are gluten-free will tell you that sometimes they drink gluten-free beer or gluten-free wine, and it just has not a good taste. This is delicious.
Okay,
that's good.
Absolutely delicious.
Even
product.
To someone who's not gluten-free,
yeah, you wouldn't even know.
Okay,
you know, it's so good.
And this one here,
and this is the Francis Coppola red wine.
Mm-hmm.
We just brought this in as well. A delicious, delicious red wine. It's amazing.
It's a nice blend.
I'm a very finicky wine drinker.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, it's not that I'm fussy finicky. I'm finicky because, you know, sometimes I don't like wine.
Sure.
Yeah,
you know,
but that's
a
good one.
That's a good one. Portsmouth Publick House.
Absolutely delicious.
Good stuff.
All right. Speaking of delicious, this recipe should be on your menu tonight. So to make it, find the recipe at WPRI.com.